torture, dick jokes, oh yeah, and a take that at religion. Welcome to the heart of the stories we tell. My name is Rob, and tonight I will be reviewing The Orville, Episode 4, If the Stars Should Appear. And last week I said that this was the spirit of Star Trek, and definitely tonight we get more of that. We get some women power, we get some ship battles, and we get a classic story. For those of you that don't know, I'm putting together a community here where we can study different stories, and being that this is a comedy, I'm just going to go over the basics of what happened and then talk about my opinion. If you're interested in my thoughts on stories, hit that subscribe button and enable alerts. Let's get started now. So like I said, it has the soul of Star Trek. We have a weird alien ship that we don't know what's going on. They're actually more advanced, but also less advanced than us. And at the same time, we have some things that need to be handled by combat, and some things that need to be handled by thinking. Of course, our command crew is always who goes down on the away missions. I will say, we haven't run into Ricky Redshirt yet. Everyone has a full name, so, you know, there's that. The show itself, like I said, was mostly a take that at religion and how religions work. But in order to get into details, let's throw this up there. So once again, it's stop. Spoiler time. So the main plot is all about Liam Neeson becoming a god, or at least being seen as one even though he wasn't. The secondary plot was mostly just a thing about how couples get along. And that's actually kind of cool, because they do couple stuff actually pretty well on this show. But okay, so the command crew goes down to this ship. This ship is a giant ark. It's got an entire civilization living within it, but one that's been without tech for so long that it's forgotten that it's on a ship. Instead, it's fallen backwards into a dark age, one where instead of technology, they're back to mysticism. And the captain of the ship is being seen as a god, the captain who's been dead for 2,000 years, because the ship was hit by a stray ion storm, I think it was. Now, if this were Trek instead of the Orville, we'd have an entire series of parts where we were just discussing the Prime Directive and whether or not they should or could interfere. Luckily, the Orville sidesteps this by just not doing it. At the same time, we would have probably not had as quick of a combat, and I really liked having the Orville go off and just smack down some bad guys. And also the jokes. There would have been less jokes. Now, we did learn a couple of things, like the fact that our head of security is super tough, and her body is more resilient, making, you know, the Superman comparison even more so. She can't openly take a bullet to the chest, but she survived longer than a human would have. Now, we also got the fact that something that we had guessed for a while now, the super-evolved member of the crew is actually an android and capable of directly interfacing with computers. It's pretty cool. Everyone actually has their own little niche. But the real story here is, what do you do when you come across someone whose beliefs aren't factual? They believe something, but you know it's not true. Well, in the case of the Orville, they proved it by opening the sunroof. But realistically, religion doesn't work that way. You don't believe unless you yourself think there's proof of it. I know that my religion, my personal one, wouldn't be questioned easily, but at the same time, I'm not just believing the entire universe exists. Last week felt like a next-gen episode to me. This one felt more like the original series, especially with how easily it was wrapped up in the end. If anything, I'd say that's the only flaw this show has. Stories that could have stretched on and been a little more in-depthly examined are quickly wrapped up to be done with by the end of the week. And Seth MacFarlane must have called in some pretty good favors to get Liam Neeson this week, and next week we have yet another guest star. Let me know, do you think that's how they're going to try to pull in the audience? I'm interested in your thoughts. Also, what do you think would have been different if this were a Trek episode? Other than, again, the Prime Directive. Let me know about that, and of course, if you're enjoying me talking about what these stories feel like to me, hit that like and share button, and of course, if this is your first time here, hit subscribe and enable alerts. I'm trying to build up a community, one where we can examine the hows and the whys of all the stories we tell. And I have to say, this one gives me a unique perspective, because there's not a lot of story to dissect, but there's a lot of feel and thought and theme and symbolism in it. So, I'm gonna maybe take next week off from the Orville, we'll see. For now, I'd like to thank you for watching and exploring the heart of the stories we tell.